Hi and welcome. We are going to create a UI element that does different things based on how you click on it, with right click, middle click, and left click. Plus, we will make sure each of these modes is available to you in the inspector, just like in the basic button component. You might have tried to recreate this behavior by inheriting from the button component in your script. Don't copy this. And once you switched back to the inspector, none of your added functionality is showing up. This is because the button script actually hides any customizations you add for reasons that are beyond me, I don't know. So instead, we will go one step deeper. See, these UI elements, they all have a common base with transition modes, interactability, and navigation. These all stem from one base class, Selectable. Create a new script and let it inherit from Selectable and nothing else for now. Create a new UI image component and add the script to it. You can already see the base showing up even though we haven't added anything yet. From here, we are basically recreating a button on our own. Add the IPointerClickHandler interface to the script so we can have the UI element react to inputs in just a moment. Add two or three Unity events based on which button on your input device has been used, typically on left click, on middle click, and on right click. And remember that maybe not every input device might be able to offer all three of these. Make sure to test it on every platform you plan to support. By using Unity events, we make sure they show up in the inspector and can be accessed just the same as the one of our basic button script. And you can add or remove listeners to them by script just like you can from the basic button component. I made a whole tutorial on that if you are interested. This protected override reset calls the base reset method of the Selectable class and makes sure our target graphic for the button gets set up correctly once the script gets attached in the inspector, or you click on the three dots in the corner and click reset. OnPointerClick takes event data as its parameter. To make sure that we get a correct state transition no matter if we click with left, middle, or right, we call the transition method first. If we leave this one out, only left click would send a signal to change the visuals. In a switch check, we check which input button has been used when the method got called. Based on input, we invoke the corresponding event. Then we need to stop a coroutine if it has been set and start a new one to correctly finish the transition. In this case, I simply copy-pasted it over from the button component itself to keep the effect consistent. If you enjoyed the tutorial so far, please click like and consider subscribing. So let's test this. I created a new script for it with three methods that log their input to the console. In the inspector, attach it to whichever game object you like, hook up the three methods to the respective event, and give it a test. Of course, you can also add them by script, just like in the original button component. If you don't know how to do that, watch my button tutorial next. Hope you enjoyed this. Have a great week.